Good morning to all. In this today's video, Unit 4, Electromagnetic Induction lesson. So in this lesson, we are going to see about the topic mean or average value of AC. So last class, we discussed about the alternating current and also the sinusoidal wave formation of the alternating current. So here in this topic, we have to find out the magnitude or value of the alternating current. There are a lot of method we have to find out this values, but in your syllabus there are two kinds are given here. We find out the value, that is the magnitude of the alternating current. So first method is mean or average. The two letters gives the same meaning, that you know. So mean or average method. Then second method is RMS value, that is root mean square method. So in the DC current, that is in the direct current, we are going to find out in a easy way, so the value of the current value. But in the AC, it is a very difficult to find out that. But there are a lot of the discussions here, but here in this lesson there are two ways, that is first method, the mean or average value of AC current. Let's see that. So you know very well, so AC current means the alternating positive and the negative half cycle can be produced in the sinusoidal wave. So that is the mean or average value of a alternating current for one complete cycle is zero. So but here we have to find out the magnitude. So how can we find out that magnitude value means? So according to this, we have to find out the mean or average value. So it is defined as the average of all the values of current over a positive half cycle. So when the sinusoidal wave means, when the current is passes through in a wave formation, suppose we have to take all the positive half of the values, or it may be the all the values of the negative half cycle. So we have to sum all the values, positive or negative half cycle, we have to average, find out the average to the base length of half cycle, because we have to take only the half of the values, no? So that's why we have to take a that is divided by base length of half cycle. So this is the formula. We are going to find out the mean value of the AC current. So this is the formula. In this way only we are finding the average value. So I average, that is the current value, is equal to area of positive half cycle or negative half cycle divided by the base length of half cycle. So in this formula, using this formula, we are find out the value of the average current value. So let's see the derivation now. Let us consider this sinusoidal wave, alternating current is passes through that. So in this graphical representation, we have to consider a elementary strip of thickness d theta, that is the red color shade, you know that, no? So that is the one of the elementary area we have to take that. So in this value, the thickness of the strip is taken as d theta, so that can be denoted as that. So and also, so I be the mid ordinate of the strip, that is I represents the mid ordinate of the strip, means that is like a length. So that value is considered as a length, that is a I value here. Now so these are all the parameters, and you know that 2 pi is the 360 degree and pi is the 180 degree, and it can be start from 0. So that line is considered as a theta. So here the elementary value is d theta. So that can be taken in the positive half cycle of the current wave. So next we have to see the derivation. Find out the area of the elementary strip. So area means length into breadth, you know that. So like length I into breadth d theta, so like that we have to take that area. And area of the positive half cycle, that can be represented as, so that can be we taken as a small d theta, that is elementary strip, you know that. So then we have to take the integral formation of that. So integration of I d theta from the minimum value of 0 to that half of the baseline, that is pi for 180 degree. So that's why pi is taken there, and I d theta is there. So is equal to, you know that I is equal to I m sin theta. That is already we discussed in the orientation of the coil. So epsilon is equal to epsilon m sin theta or sin omega t. So here also that I value is also, induced current is also I is equal to Im sin omega t. So here we have to take that theta value here. So I is equal to, small I is equal to Im sin theta d theta. Substitute that value. The next step then is equal to, you have to take the constant value outside. So Im, so integration of sin theta d theta minus cos theta. So substitute that value. So is equal to Im minus cos theta, and also substitute the limit value, lower limit 0, upper limit pi, is equal to, take it out the minus value outside, so minus Im. So upper value, upper limit minus lower limit, substitute the limit in inside that, then upper limit minus lower limit, so cos pi minus cos 0. So here cos pi, that is cos 180 minus 1 and also cos 0 1. So minus 1 minus 1 totally minus 2. Then outside there is one of the minus is there, minus into minus plus. So 2im. So this is the final value. So I average is equal to 2im. So sorry, this is not a I average, this is the total value of all the positive values, that is upper positive value. So that is equal to 2im. Then substitute this value in the general formula. So what is the formula? I average is equal to sum of the, that is total of the all the positive or negative half cycle divided by base length, half of the base length. So the total value is 2im divided by half of the base length pi. So here 2 is also constant, pi value is also constant, then you have to substitute the Im value. Im means that is the maximum amplitude value, that is the maximum peak of the I value here, maximum current. So here substitution of 2 pi pi, pi value 3.14, 2 divided by 3.14, the value is 0.637. So 0.637 times of Im. So that is the average value of AC current. And also for the negative half cycle, so the sign only we have to change, that is a negative symbol. So I average is equal to minus 0.637 Im. So this is the value. So this is the value of the AC current. And also the another method of the finding the value of AC current is RMS value of AC, that is root mean square. So here according to that, that is also we have to substitute one of the formula, that the formula is the root mean square. That means the root mean of, that is the square root of mean of the squares of all currents over one cycle, positive or negative. So all the one cycle, that I square value divided by, so that is divided by base length of one cycle, the whole full cycle we have to take that. So for the previous case we have to take the half length only. So in this case, area of one cycle of squared wave divided by base length of one cycle. So you just see that formula and you know that. So this is the formula we have to find out, that is R I RMS is equal to root of area of one cycle of squared wave divided by base length of one cycle. Now let's find out the squared wave here. So in this graphical representation shows the square waves. Suppose we have to consider the red color wave is a sinusoidal wave. We have to consider a blue dotted line, that is a square of the current value. So for a negative half cycle, that is also we have to consider as a positive value, that is the whole cycle. So positive and negative, that is a one cycle. So here that one cycle we taken as the, let us imagine that, that is a dotted for a upper values, the both in the upper values. So I square, the doubled of the I current is called the I square. And also we have to consider a small elementary strip also, like the d theta, and I square value is we have to take. Then we have to find out the, so take the constant value outside, I square m, integration of sin square theta d theta. So sin square d theta is also, maybe we have to rewritten as 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So that's why substitute instead of sine square theta, 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So it can be splitted into the two terms. That is, we have to take the 1 by 2 value outside. Then inside, 1 minus cos 2 theta value is there. So for multiplying the d theta value inside the bracket, so I square m divided by 2 integration of d theta minus integration of cos 2 theta d theta. Then it may be integration of d theta theta minus 2 cos 2 theta d theta means sin 2 theta divided by 2, and also substitute the limit values, that is 0 to 2 pi. Here substitute the limit values here, upper limit minus lower limit. The first column, see that we have to substitute the upper limit value minus of second column 0. So I square m divided by 2 here. Instead of theta, upper limit you substitute that 2 pi minus sine 2 instead of theta 2 pi divided by 2. So minus of here substitute the value of 0. So 0 minus sine 0 divided by 2. You know very well that sine 0 0, and also for one complete cycle 4 pi is also 0. So that's why all the values, that is sine 2 pi value is also 0, sine 0 is also 0. That term can be cancelled. Here one of the 0 term is there, that is also cancelled. Only we have to take the first one, that is 2 pi only, that value. So last final answer, I square m divided by 2 into 2 pi. So that is the value. 2 cancel, and finally I square m pi. So that is the value. You know the value of pi value, 3.14. So that is the value of the area of one cycle of squared wave. So that can be substituted in the general RMS value. So IRMS is equal to root of that area value divided by the base length of one cycle. So substitute that value, I square m pi by 2 pi is equal to Im by, that is pi pi cancel, root 2. So here root 2, then square values also cancel for I value. So that's why in the base only, root 2 only we have that. So 1 by root 2 value, substitute the root 2 value here, and 1 divided by that value is 0.707 Im. So here the value of current, the magnitude of the current is, so we have to find out that the sinusoidal current for the RMS value of current is the 0.7077 into Im. So here this is the value of the current. The peak value means it can be converted into the percentage. So percentage, 70.7%. So similarly for the voltage is also. So here the current value is found at, voltage value is also for that the same value. That is VRMS is equal to 0.707 Vm also. So this is the values of the current.